Yo, check it, Booyakasha. We bumping that new Travis Scott. What you know about it? Today we're here in Croatia with my boys, Boka.
What the fuck are you saying?
We're about to get some scooters and scoot around. As you know, that's one of my favorite things to do. Thank you for watching. Where are you watching from? Comment down below. And see you guys on the next scene. How's it look?
Living that life.
Alright, so we got some real
big body
scooters here. Well, these are motorbikes here. So right here we have 250 cc's. Right here we have 125 cc's. And I'll be honest, I've actually never driven 250 cc before.
What the fuck are you doing?
But you gotta tell them that you have. But
let's ride a sucker. So, where are we going?
Let's ride a sucker. I don't know where we're going.
Hey,
but
where should we go?
Yeah.
I don't know what you want. Beaches or clouds or what?
No, we want like open space. Nature.
Just go. You will see. For about, I don't know, maybe 5 kilometers, you will see a lot of sea.
Yeah. Just keep driving.
Just go, just follow the main street.
Okay.
And you will see everything.
All the way.
All right. That's it.
All right.
Guys, have a nice day.
Thank you, man.
Thank
see you,
brother.
Tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Yes.
See you tomorrow morning.
Everyone, Luca Rent Agency. Hit them up. They're chill. All right, that's it for the big cam for now. See you on the GoPro. All
right, just got on the big boat. This thing is a boat. And I'm feeling amazing. As I always say, being on a motorbike, cruising through the tropics, you feel so free, and it makes it feel so good. So here we go, cruising around small island in Croatia. Let's get it!
Oh yeah.
Sweet. That tunnel was
trippy.
Tunnel vision. That was a trip for sure. I was like, oh, I hope these broken headlights work. Probably not.
Oh. Alright, here we are in Stari Grad. Oh! My GoPro is covered in some salt or something, it looks like. Stari Grad, another.
Oh my god, look at this.
Yeah, little cobblestone.
You know, stone town.
Harbor town. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
20 for two?
Salute. Yeah.
20 total?
Yes, a $1.50 each.
Oh my gosh.
Nice. It's really nice.
So nice.
Hi.
Dude, it's the future. Public workout stations.
Yeah.
It's the future, man. We're telling you guys.
It's coming.
Future, just like random pull-up bar stations, random sit-up stations.
Yeah, figure it out. Urban workouts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No excuses these days.
What's up, guys? I'm coming at you from a small harbor town somewhere in the Mediterranean today. And welcome back to another episode of Real Quick, where I explain shit very quick. Right now, I'm making a video about the number one mistake that tourists make while taking videos on vacation. It's a good one, right? So I'm gonna explain this real quick for you guys, and hopefully it's gonna make your vacation better. Let me explain the context. So the context is I have been living abroad for 11 months out of the year for the past almost 4 years now, and I've been to lots of touristy places. This is the number one thing that tourists do when I cringe. The number one mistake that people do, get ready for it, is they're holding their phones like while they're walking and filming, and they're just flailing their phones all around. They're like, oh, look at this, 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 look at this. Oh, let's film this. Oh, let's film that over here, and then back to this, and then this. Keep your freaking phone steady.
Great.
And I'm saying this because I'm very guilty of this, even sometimes still. And I'm a YouTuber for fucking 3 years. If you want to have good home movies, a good solid video with your phone, if you want to film something like this beautiful view of this harbor, stop, take your phone, and either hold it steady,
you're lucky,
just don't move it at all, and hold it for 10 seconds. Get 10 second long clips steady. Or do smooth, very slow movement. And I still do this too. I move my phone or my GoPro or my camera too quick. Slowly, count to five, at least. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then keep walking. I know it can be a hassle, and it's still a hassle for me all the time. Like, I'm walking here with Danny, I'm walking with Parker. I have to stop and then get the shot of the harbor or whatever you're filming. If you try to film something while you're still walking, I'm telling you, it's gonna be worth it to just stop and get the smooth shot. I had the idea to do this video today because I just saw a grandpa like walking like this. He was doing landscape, but he was just walking around, filming while he's walking. It's gonna be good footage, but it's gonna be bumpy, and later, you know, his grandkids are gonna be watching this, it's gonna be all bumpy and crappy. Grandpa, just stop, get the shot, walk to the next place, slow and steady. Too many people are 1 second here, 1 second here, 1 second here, 1 second here. Anyways, you get it. Same thing with GoPros. People are like, oh, cool, look at that. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's cool. Cool. Oh, my God, did you see that? And then they're pointing the camera. Another quick tip, people tend to point the camera at your eyes. This is what we naturally want to do. What you actually want to do is point the camera at your mouth. So your eyes are on the top half of the screen, like it is right now on this camera. Anyways, all right, ran it too long. Let me know if that blew your mind, and share this with someone who's about to go on vacation, because I just made your home movies better. Mwah. So those were just the basics, the things to keep in mind if you're a beginner. If you're more advanced and you want to get into like making dope ass travel videos, check the link below to the full course on how to make the sickest travel videos. And I'll see you over there. Let me know where you're coming from. Comment your city and someone will get a shout out. Peace. All right, Stari Grad, you were good. Mwah. That is a great 30-minute, 20-minute drive from Hvar City. Stari. I recommend you do it. Stari. How you feeling about that?
Tripping. That's tripping, man.
That was fun right
Croatian
there.
Croatian mountain, Croatian hillside. Side of a mountain. Las Montañas, I throw a football over them.
Yo,
That was fun. This bike is so comfy. This is the biggest
That's a boat.
This is the biggest boat I've ever driven.
Looks cool. And, oh my god, look at this, dude.
Yeah.
Village.
Yeah.
We passed.
Yeah.
A bunch of stone cribs up there.
Yeah. This is, whoa, pure ocean. Oh yeah. So sick. I think this is the best viewpoint we're gonna get.
Oh man, look at that.
Puddle. Coming at you from somewhere in the Mediterranean region of the world.
Croatia. Coming at you from Croatia.
Coming at you from Croatia. We got our big boy bikes.
Big boy.
Lex got a 125. I got a big boy.
Champagne.
250.
Uh-huh.
And look at this view, boys. So, figured this would be a good little stop to do a quick update video that I've been meaning to do for a while. Have you heard of, like, Hero's Journey? This is what you do. This is what Matt Laker told me. So, I've been doing an okay job of this recently. Every once in a while, you gotta continue to tell your story. At this point, during today's vlog, why don't we provide a little bit of context for everyone, turn it into the program. So we've been living abroad in tropical countries for the past 3.5 years now. And we've met a lot of travelers, tourists, and blown a lot of minds telling people what we do. We work online and based in Thailand. So when people ask, like, yeah, what do you do? We're like, yeah, we live in Bangkok now, and yeah, we work online. Oh, yeah, that, oh, interesting, cool, wow, that's great. You know, for a lot of people, it doesn't even, they've never even thought of, like, working online and living in a random place around the world before. So I'm gonna give you guys the elevator pitch in 1 second. So the elevator pitch for my story and Parker's story and Danny's story as well is, for a lot of expats, people that live abroad, live in other countries, it all starts most of the time with a short vacation. So Parker did a 2-month semester abroad in Thailand with our university, Washington State University. So after I had graduated a year ahead of Parker, and Parker was out to Thailand during his last semester, and he would literally call me and Danny and be like, you guys have to get out here, this is so cool, right? Like, you remember that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
And so we did.
Yeah.
So we fucking went.
And so we were, like, planning, like, up to this point, we have been, we were all recent grads, or at least Danny and I were, and I was basically sleeping on your couch for the first year after college. Because I didn't want to live at home. I just hated living at home, so I just basically slept at your place. And we would watch a lot of, like, video about Tokyo, and, like, we all really wanted to go to Tokyo, and we found this really dope hyperlapse of Guangzhou, China, and ended up last year, last October, fulfilling the dream of going to Guangzhou, China. I lived there for a month, freaking doing business, sourcing physical products. That's our business, but we'll get there in a second.
Let's go!